topic is basic concepts of HOOP and HOOP stands for Object Oriented Programming. HOOP is one of the object oriented programming. An object means it is one of the runtime entities such as person, place, things. Object oriented programming. And programming means it will be controlled in the set of instructions or information. And object oriented programming, it will be used to mainly used for designing the and developing the software. And in our real life applications, we have to use for object oriented programming designing the software. That is one of the advantage of object oriented programming. And in programming methods, there will be two programming methods will be there, object oriented programming, another one will be the procedure oriented programming. So what is the difference between object oriented programming and procedure oriented programming? Object oriented programming and procedure oriented programming. So in procedure oriented programming means it will be mainly depending upon the procedures or algorithms. An algorithm means it is one of the step by step procedures. And procedure oriented programming, it will be mainly depending upon the procedures or algorithm. In object oriented programming, it is mainly depending upon the objects. And second one difference is, on procedure oriented programming, it follows top down approach. Object-oriented programming, it follows bottom-up approach. And next one, that will be the procedure-oriented programming language, like for example C programming. C programming is one of the procedure-oriented programming language, and object-oriented programming languages like, for example, C++, Java. And in procedure oriented programming, it will be mainly depending upon the procedures. It cannot support object, class, inheritance, polymorphism, dynamic binding, message passing concept. But in object oriented programming, it will support class, object, polymorphism, data hiding, data encapsulation. So these are the concepts are supported by object oriented programming. So these are the some differences between procedure oriented programming and object oriented programming. So and next one concept, like what are the characteristics of object oriented programming? What are the characteristics of object oriented programming? And object oriented programming, it will be support several characteristics. The first one characteristic, like that will be the object. An object is one of the runtime entities such as person, place, things. That is generally we have to know about object. An object, it will be containing several data members and associated member functions. For example, apple, mango, banana. So these are the objects of class fruits. Apple, mango, banana. So these are the objects of class fruit. Of class fruit. Orange, mango, banana, apple. So these are the objects of class fruit. For example, student is one of the objects. Student is one of the objects. It contains the data members like student name, registration number, fees. So these are the data members or member data. It associated with member functions like get data, display. So these are the member functions. So an object, it will be containing the data members and associated member function. Student name, register number, fees. So these are the data members. Get the data, display, these are the member functions. And next one, characteristic like that will be the class. And class is one of the keyword, and keyword means it is one of the predefined word, and class it is one of the user defined data type, and data type that will be defined by the user. User means people who write the computer programs, that is generally defined as the user. And class is one of the user defined data type. It is also containing the grouping of or collection of objects. It will be containing the some unique name. It will be containing some unique name, and it will be containing its own behavior. That is generally defined as the class. And class is generally defined as collection of objects. And for example, we have to take as sun, moon. Sun, moon, star, star. So these are the objects of class solar system. Of class solar system. Solar system is one of the class. Sun, moon, stars, these are the objects. So that is one of the example for class. And next one, that will be now. Next one, characteristic like data abstraction. And data abstraction means it is an essential feature without including background details of explanation. So it cannot including background details or explanation. And data abstraction means it is an essential feature without including background details or explanations. And next one, characteristic like data encapsulation. And data encapsulation means the wrapping up of data and function combined to form a single unit, that is generally defined as data encapsulation. And data encapsulation enables data hiding or information hiding. And data encapsulation, it enables the hiding the information. That is one of the characteristic of hope. And next one, characteristic like inheritance. Inheritance, it is one of the characteristic of object-oriented programming. It is one of the process that inherit the properties from one class to another class. So an inheritance contains two classes like base class and another one will be the that is derived class. I hope support inheritance concept. Inheritance means it is the process of inherit the properties from one class to another class, that is generally defined as inheritance. It contains two classes like base class and derived class. Base class means the existing class is known as base class, and derived class means whose properties can be inherited by the base class, that is generally defined as derived class. For example, father is one of the base class and son is one of the derived class. That is one of the example for inheritance. And next one concept like that will be the polymorphism. Polymorphism concept. Poly means many, morphism means forms. Polymorphism means many forms. It is an ability to take more than one form, that is generally defined as polymorphism. For example, we consider the plus is one of the operator. It can be designed more than one form, like it can be written as a plus b plus ab, AB plus. So on plus is one of the operator that can be written more than one form, that is generally defined as polymorphism. And hope support polymorphism concept. It is an ability to take more than one form. And next one characteristic like Mrs. Fossil. Next one characteristic like message passing, and message means information. In we have to sending the messages or receiving the messages, it will be improve the communication. And hope it also support the message passing concept used for communication, and it will be used to sending the messages to the object. And next one that will be characteristic dynamic binding. Dynamic binding. So it is one of the characteristic of hook. Binding means we are linking the program, linking the one program to another program, that is generally defined as binding. And dynamic binding means the code associated with a given procedure call during the execution of the program. We have to use it for one of the concepts that will be the dynamic binding. It is one of the characteristic of hope. So these are the characteristics of hope supported by object oriented programming. And next one concept like that will be the what are the benefits or what are the advantages of object oriented programming. Advantages of hope or benefits of object oriented programming. The first one advantage like it support modular efficient concept. So modularization means the lengthier problem that will be split into small problem. And hope support object modularization concept, it will be the lengthier program that will be split into small program or problem, that is generally defined as modularization. And hope support modularization concept, that is one of the advantage of object oriented programming. And next one like gets one advantage like that will be the it is used to implement the complex software. Easy to implement the complex software. So we have to easy to analyzing or we easy to developing the software using object oriented programming. And next one advantage like it supports message passing concept. We have to use it for communication. It supports message passing concept. Use it for communication. Use it for communication. And next one advantage like it provides the data security. It provides data security. We have to reduce the program size and also code reusability. We have to reusing the code many times. That is code reusability. So these are some advantages of object oriented programming. Modularization, easy to implement in the complex software, and hook supports message passing concept, used for communication, and also it will be provides the data security. And next one advantage or benefit like code reusability. We have to reusing the code many times. So these are the some advantages of object oriented programming. And next one concept like applications of object oriented programming. So where we have to use it for object oriented programming. Next one concept like applications of object oriented programming. An object oriented programming we have to use it for in many ways. The first one will like that will be the CAD/CAM system software. And next one application like object oriented database. And next one advantage like next one application like that will be computer graphics applications. Next one application like that will be the hypertext and hypermedia. And an object oriented programming also used for artificial intelligence. Some applications of object oriented programming, CAD/CAM system software, object oriented database, computer graphics applications, hypertext and hypermedia, artificial intelligence. So these are the various ways we have to use it for object oriented programming. And the last concept is what are the drawbacks of object oriented programming. Limitations of object-oriented programming. limitation. Next one concept is limitations of object oriented programming, and what are the drawbacks of what are the disadvantages of object oriented programming. The first one limitation is larger program size. Larger program in size. In object-oriented programming, it will be required more number of lines in the program. It will be increases the number of lines in the program. That is one of the disadvantage of object-oriented programming. Larger program in size. It is one of the disadvantage of object-oriented programming. And next one disadvantage like slower program. And slower program is considered, we have to consider the procedure-oriented programming language. It is executed very fast compared to the object-oriented programming language. That is one of the disadvantage of object-oriented programming, slower program. It will be executed slow compared to procedure-oriented programming language. And next one, like disadvantage, like every problem, every real-world problem that will be converted into classes and objects. Every real-world problem converted into classes and objects. It is one of the difficult process. That is one of the disadvantage of object-oriented programming. So every real-world problem convert into classes and objects. It is one of the difficult process. That is one of the disadvantage of object-oriented programming. And next one disadvantage like that will be the classes are overly generalizing. So these are the some disadvantages of object-oriented programming. Larger programming size, slower program, real-world problem converted into classes and object. It is one of the complex process, and last one, that is classes are overly generalized. So these are the some disadvantages of object-oriented programming. So this chapter carries 7 marks, 5 marks 1 question and 2 marks 1 question. Total 7 marks.